In the previous units, we introduced two parts of the internet: the network edges and the access network's physical media, which are the lines and components used to connect to the network. In the upcoming units, we'll learn about the third part, which is the heart of the internet, the network core. The network core mostly consists of a very large network of routers and the lines between them intended to transmit data to the right place. The data, in the form of a message, is divided into units named packets. The data can be divided either between hosts or between the routers themselves. The reason for dividing the data into smaller units mostly stems from the properties of the infrastructure and the memory volumes in the routers. With every sending of data from host to host, every router on the message's path calculates which is the next router on the route and passes the message forward to its destination. How can we calculate the time it takes a message to arrive from a transmitting to a receiving host? We'll denote the bandwidth with R. The bandwidth represents the rate at which information can be transmitted into the line. The measurement unit for bandwidth is usually BPS, bytes per second. We'll denote the size of the message with L. The size of the message is measured with volume units, such as the amount of bytes in the message, the number of bits, and so on. The formula for calculating the time it takes to transmit the message fully is the size of the message over the bandwidth, that is, L over R. After transmission, it takes time for the message to get to the next point and additional infrastructure delays, but at this stage we'll consider them negligible for the sake of the demonstration. Routers work in the store and forward method, storing data and forwarding it. That means the router stores the entire message in memory and only later transmits it forward to the receiving point. The router also has additional delays which we'll neglect. If we look at the following example where there is exactly one router between the sending and receiving point, we'll get that the total time for the entire process is a full transmission of the message from the transmitting point, receiving the full message in the router, and then transmission of the message from the router and receiving in the receiving point. The total process has twice the transmission of the message, once at the transmitting point and once in the router. The formula we get is 2L over R. If we generalize the case for two routers on the route between sender and receiver, we'll get 3L over R. And in the general case of K routers, we'll get K plus 1 times L over R. We emphasize that this is a very superficial calculation which neglects a lot of parameters, such as the time messages take to get from component to component and additional delays. Additionally, the calculation assumes that the message does reach its destination without any garbling or delays, that the routers have sufficient memory capacity, and that the bandwidth of all lines is identical, that the message doesn't undergo processing in the routers which would delay the whole process even further. Let's say the size of the transmitted message is 7.5 megabytes, which is 7.5 million bytes. Let's assume the bandwidth is 1.5 megabytes per second. In this case, each of the points along the route will take 7.5 megabytes divided by 1.5 megabytes per second. That is, 5 seconds. If there is one router between the points, the whole process will take 10 seconds. If there are two routers, the process will take 15 seconds, and so on. As I already mentioned, the previous example made many assumptions that are not realistic. Each router has memory managed as a kind of queue. Messages entering the router are automatically saved in the queue, and messages transmitted from the router are deleted from the queue. The size and the speed of the queue depend on the type of router. We need to add the time of waiting in the queue to the time of the entire process in each of the routers. This time is hard to predict since it depends on the load on each router at that point in time. But it's possible to do probability analysis and estimate the queue time approximately. Likewise, the router processes the packets and manipulates them in ways we'll learn later in the course. These router processing times should also be added to the total time calculation of the process. Assuming the rate of arrival of data into the router from a single point or a number of points is higher than the rate of the router transmitting the data forward, the messages will be preserved in the queue and wait for processing and transmission. If this situation continues for a period of time long enough to fill the queue capacity, messages will be lost and not saved in the queue. For example, let's say that at each second, 10 messages arrive, but only 8 are transmitted. In this situation, every second, 2 messages are added to the queue. If we assume that the queue size is 20, and the messages keep coming at the same rate, then after 10 seconds the queue will fill entirely, and excess messages arriving afterward won't be saved. Such a situation will cause information loss. In this unit, we started looking into the third part of the Internet, the network core. We estimated the time it takes to transmit a message from the transmitting to the receiving hosts and understood a few important issues occurring inside the routers.